And now to a special video about the Apopka High School wrestling team.
Okay, people, it's FCAT time. We need to talk about this. FCAT, remember Florida Comprehensive Assessment Test? Seems like some of you people think it means forget about the assessment test. I need to make room for new people coming up from eighth grade and from middle school. Let's get with the program. All you gotta do is pay attention to the teachers that are giving you practice exams and practice work. It's not impossible. It just takes some focus. Focus on the comprehensive assessment test and you'll have no problem. Can I ask you to do that? Let's go, people. Come on. This is for real. What are you doing? Looking at me, staring at me. I said study, focus on the comprehensive assessment test. Now go.
I've been playing lacrosse for about 2 years. My friend started out and he said, come on out. So I went out and then I was like, ooh, I kind of like this. So that's pretty much why I started playing lacrosse. My favorite thing about lacrosse is probably the face-off because I like to fight for the ball, so that's what you do at the beginning, so yeah. Yes, I do want to go to Division II so I can play lacrosse in college. The funniest moment was laying Dustin out on the sideline, and as he was going down, he was laughing. And it was hilarious.
And Spanish Honor Society members, next meeting will be on Monday, February 25th. If you need a cultural event, see Ms. Lowe this week.
And now to a student spotlight from our DNN reporter, Mark Christmas.
And a break from us.
And Karen Buck. I'm 17 years old. I got accepted to University of North Florida for summer session. I want to become a registered dietitian. Erica Captain and the Cowboy, I'm a hostess.
Alright, what grade are you in?
The National Wild Turkey Foundation scholarship deadline has been extended.
Longer.
Seniors who have a hunting license should see the volunteers in the What's Next room for an application.
Gobble, gobble.
What's Next room?
Girls lacrosse will have a home game tonight.
Tonight.
JV will begin at 6 o'clock and varsity at 7:30. Come on and cheer on the Lady Blue Darters against the Lake Mary Rams. The action is unbelievable. You better be there. So that's been all today for Apopka, for us. too on your broadcast. I hope you guys have a great Wednesday and we're peacing
out. See
you
later.
Bye.
Have a good day.
Congratulations to both water polo teams for beating Colonial yesterday. The girls won with a score of 15-2. Junior Shauna Portilla led with 8 goals. Senior Bobby Auden scored 4 times. Sophomore Catherine Walker scored 2 times and senior Kate Walker scored 1. The defense was led by seniors Rochelle Edmondson, Courtney Bostick, and Katie Walker. Their record is now 2-0. The boys won with a score of 18-9. They were led in points by sophomore Tyler Costello with 9 goals. Sophomore Richie Hittlebrand scored 3 times. Senior Drew Friedman and sophomore Brad Russell scored 2 times, and junior Matt Lawrence and sophomore Andrew Gettles each scored 1. The defense was led by goalies Drew Friedman and Josh Glidden and sophomores Andrew Gettle and Brad Russell. Their score is now 1-1. Sorry if I mispronounced any names.
And now to a video from DNN reporter Matt Lawrence about the water polo team.
To an FCAT commercial brought back, demanded from one and only Desmond Pickard.
Hell yeah, let the FCATs around the corner, it's right around the corner. Come March, you will have to take the FCAT. 10th, 9th, 11th, and some of y'all 12th graders. You gotta take the FCAT. You might not know when, you might not know how, but I come to tell you that you gonna have to take it anyway. You might not want to. You might wake up, sleepy in your eyes, but I come to tell you, the FCAT is here. It's right around the corner, waiting for you. What you gonna do? I'ma tell you what you gonna do. It's go to sleep early, get a good rest. Sleep on it, and don't talk on that telephone. You need to sleep on it, and then you wake up in the morning and you eat a good breakfast. You eat a good breakfast, not no sugar candy, not your sugar daddy. Don't eat no fried food. You need some eggs, some toast, even a piece of ham. You need something to stir up your mind, to wake you up, to get ready. Drink a cup of OJ, because we all know OJ will do it, because OJ did it. And you also need to prepare yourself. Read a FCAT book, do FCAT practice, go to FCATExplore.com, do what you gotta gotta do to get what you need to get, cause you only can do what you can do in your own power. And when you go in that test, stick your head up high, stick your chest out, and get ready to conquer the FCAT. If you're ready, do what I told you to do.
And now to today's major story from DNN reporter John Young.
Hello, Apopka. I'm Jonathan Young from the DNN News Network. And if you've ever driven off 441, you know how bad the traffic is. Have you ever wished for a solution? Well, right now, the Hubbard Construction Company is working on one. And I interviewed some of the workers there to see how they get the job done.
First up is Antoine Goyi, the project engineer supervisor.
My name is Antoine Gulley. I am a project engineer for Hubbard Construction Company on the State Road 414 Mainland Boulevard job. My role as a project engineer is to supervise all of the dirt operations on the job. There's another project engineer on the job that handles all the bridge operations. The project we have here is a $90 million project for the Orlando-Orange County Expressway Authority, and it consists of three bridges and basically a new roadway that will eventually tie in the existing Maple Boulevard into 429. After our project, there's a series of two other projects that are being built by Ranger Construction and by Johnson Brothers that tie into 429. Like I said, the cost of the project is approximately $90 million. As far as the number of crews that we have on this project, there's gonna be up to 12 bridge crews building the job. And on the roadway side, we'll have about 4 to 6 crews at any given time. There will be 2 crews working on the phasing on 441, and about 3 or 4 crews on the main line on 414. We also have a lot of subcontractors on site. There's about $25 million of our cost that is being done by subcontractors. That includes pile driving operations, MSC walls, and all the underground work. The schedule, the contract duration is 730 days, which is 2 years, which means that we have until June 4th of 2009 to complete the project. Right now, we're looking at beating that schedule by about a month or two, so we're hoping to be done by April, May of 2009.
The next guy interviewed is Jeremy Hubbard.
Yeah, I'm a field engineer on this job, and field engineer, the duties really entail quantity tracking. That's the number one thing. We need to know the quantity of what we're doing in order to be able to find out, you know, how we're doing cost-wise. We have budgets to drive pile, budgets to dig holes, budgets to pour concrete and this and that, and we need to know. We know what we're spending. We know what you know through, you know, we know what we're paying, but we need to know how much, and that way we get that. So I do that. I track quantity, and I also track the cost. I also track the material that we get on the job. And that's field engineering, really. And also just, it's really figuring out how, it's figuring out what, where, when, how also, because the engineering part comes into that. I need to know how things are built. It's the only way I'm gonna progress in my career and move up is knowing more. I mean, I have an engineering degree, so that's what it boils down to.
Next, Jeremy Hubbard takes me out to the field to show me what exactly they do.
That is a 150-ton capacity crane. That is holding those forms. That other crane is a 50-ton picker, 50-ton capacity, that's holding the steel upright. We gotta have vertical tension on all that stuff, otherwise it'll just fall apart. You know, so everything's gotta be supported. And they got man lifts so that they can bolt and all these steel forms together. Everything is steel forms. If it was wooden forms, it'd take forever. Here's the thing. This is a 2-year job. We commence June 4th, 2007, and we will be done June 2nd, 2009. Substantial completion will be a little over a year from now, meaning the thing will be done, but then we gotta do all these little touch-ups and satisfy all the specifications. That takes an extra 3 to 4 months, so there you go. Okay, here, this big red crane you see here is a 200-ton AAA crane, 888 crane from Manitowoc, up there in Wisconsin. And that is, its main purpose is to drive pile, like a concrete piling. Hubbard is driving the concrete piling on this job and the steel piling, which makes up about half. Half is concrete, half is steel.
The steel piling was done by our subcontractor that had that hydraulic hammer you saw before. In this case, I'll show you. Here, I'll park this thing. We'll go take a look at this.
Driving hammer for concrete piling. That is, the weight of that hammer is 50,000 pounds. The ram, which contributes to actually hitting the pile, is 23,500 pounds. That's a lot of weight on it. And it usually, to drive one of these concrete pilings, which you see one of one sticking up in the air there, and you see the other little stubby ones that have been driven further, they're driven 100 feet into the ground. And it takes about an hour to drive each one. And our hammer, beautiful thing. It's got the capacity, it doesn't break down, it's like a reliable car, you know?
Back inside, I see a map of the project, and Jeremy shows it to me on MapQuest. This is a map of the actual project. As you can see, it's just under 2 miles, so it's a very big project, and this is only a part of it.
All right, now, here is, here is, for instance, I-4, going on I-4, but you want to go down Maitland Boulevard. This will show right here. So I-4, you go down Maitland Boulevard, follow the hand right here, and then it dead ends. That's what everybody knows. What the 414 John Lambda Popka Expressway is going to be is a tollway from where 441 and 414 intersect, which you know now, all the way out. It's going to be a tollway starting there all the way out to the new 429 interchange just near Lake Apopka. So Apopka's here, the interchange is here, our job is way here, you know, 7 or 8 miles west, and it is going to go all through this wasteland that with junkyards and a bunch of empty fields and quarries or whatever. It's this is all going to be in going cutting through here. So this is you see 441 here, 429 here, we connect this, and then this is it'll stay the road everybody knows from I-4 all the way to Bear Lake / Rose Avenue near 441, but then from there on it becomes a tollway with a bunch of bridges and overpasses and our gigantic viaduct connecting all the way out to 429. So to sum up, I-4 to 429 becomes a reality instead of being the mess that everybody knows, having to go 441 and twists and turns and all this stuff through the horrible traffic in downtown Apopka. Our extension of Maitland Boulevard will solve that problem.
So by June 4th, 2009, the project will be done, lowering all the traffic on the 441. I'm Jonathan Young from the 4th period DNN, signing out. Have a good day, Apopka.
Hey, Apopka, this is Lauren Kate reporting to you for the 4th period DNN. Everyone at Apopka High School has heard about the new cell phone policy, but I decided to find out how Apopka students are reacting to it. Let's go find out.
The new cell phone policy states that all cell phones must be turned off and out of sight during school hours. With your first offense, your phone will be confiscated, you will be entered into a database. Your second offense includes Wednesday school, and your third offense results in a 3-day suspension. Many students at Apopka High School have voiced their opinion on the new cell phone policy.
Hi, I'm Josh Glidden, and I personally don't like the new cell phone policy because if you're going to text and do whatever in class, you're just not paying attention and it's going to hurt your grade. So, I mean, I think that's your own responsibility. And if you text in class, you should face consequences, not really have to give your phone up because that's dumb. And that's just my opinion.
Hi, my name is Lindsay Rice, and I think the new cell phone policy is stupid because I think we should be able to use our phones in between classes and stuff. People can do it at Wakaiva, and it's still Orange County, so I don't see why we can't do it here in Apopka.
Do you think that the new policy is working?
I don't think the new cell phone policy is working at all because there's not one single class that I'm in that someone doesn't text, and every day, every class period.
think the load, I think it's really stupid, and I think that the policy kind of makes people want to use their cell phones more, just because it's human nature to want to rebel and do what you want. So I think it's just totally backfiring, and kids use their cell phones anyway. It's not really a big deal.
So you don't think that the policy has made a difference?
I don't think it's changed one bit.
Because of these mixed feelings, I went straight to the source, Mr. Floyd. Why did you make the new cell phone policy?
Essentially, we had students taking advantage of the current old cell phone policy. And to be honest with you, we had gotten loose ourselves in enforcing it. We have so many kids that were calling friends to come up and get in situations when their friends would come up, or calling their parents in the middle of a class, or receiving calls in the middle of a class, and it was very, very distracting. It seemed like everything else that we did didn't get their attention, so we need to come down a little harder on them to make them understand that's just not right.
What do you want every student to know about the new policy?
Important points are to understand that we will be consistent in it. You know, if you violate the policy, you're going to pay the consequence. So just make everybody's life easier and just kind of follow the rules.
What do you think about other schools in the county with a more lenient cell phone policy, such as Edgewater and Wekiva, who allow their students to use their cell phones in between classes and at lunch?
Well, actually, those two schools are going out on a limb. The county policy is you don't use cell phones at all during the day, so they're actually being a little lighter. I haven't talked to those principals to know how it's working for them, but I do know that our new policy is working very well for us, so we're going to stay with it.
Okay, Apopka, you heard it from the boss, and it doesn't sound like the cell phone policy is changing anytime soon, so make sure you keep your cell phone away and off all day.
It's Kelsey from first period DNN. This year is the first time ever that AHS Varsity Cheerleading is competing. I wonder how they're doing.
In order for us to be considered a sport, we have to participate in a state competition. And we've been deemed a sport this year after a practice run at it last year. So this year we'll start competing, and that way we can be governed under the athletic department and not just a club.
Okay, we have 20 girls on our competition team, and we are competing in the varsity all-girls division of cheerleading.
The state competition will be held in Boca Raton this year. It's the first ever high school competition. It's at FAU. There are 52 teams in our division, and 15 of those teams will make it to finals.
I can learn to pity fools as I'm the worst of all, and I can't stop feeling.
I like cheerleading because it's a lot of fun, and I love bonding with my teammates. I think competing this season is a great way for our team to show off our skills to other teams. Well, we've been practicing a lot, so I think we're going to do pretty darn good at this competition, so those other teams better watch out.
The squad must perform a routine where they stunt, tumble, cheer, and dance all in about 3 minutes' time.
Looks like they've been working really hard. If you see a cheerleader, make sure you wish them good luck for this weekend. I'm Kelsey Bird from DNN1.
Want to wish someone good luck on St. Patrick's Day? Want a cookie? Freshman class will be pre-ordering cookies and a message during lunch on Wells campus over the next 2 weeks. That will be distributed in the morning on St. Patrick's Day, March 17th. It's only 50 cents for a sugar cookie and $1 for a frosted cake style like you get at Publix.
Beta Club council members, there's an executive council meeting after school today in room 210.
And now an FCAT commercial for today from your anchors Ryan and Shaq.
How are we ever going to pass the FCAT?
Hey, what's that?
Oh, that's an FCAT.
What's an FCAT?
He's half F, half cat, and 100% pretty cool.
Oh, what's he do?
He helps kids pass the FCAT.
Ah, that's cool. Hey, kids. FCAT, what do we need to do to pass the FCAT? That's easy. All you need to do is study.
Oh.
But that's only the first step. You need to get a good night's rest, so get to bed early.
Anything else?
I wasn't finished.
Sorry.
The number one tip I can give you is to eat a good breakfast, because if you don't, you won't pass and you'll end up being a nobody.
Wow, FCAT. Thanks.
Applications for next year's yearbook staff are now available. Be a part of history and help create the first yearbook in our new facility. Please see Ms. Springer in room 127 to pick up your application. There are a limited number of openings for next year, so get your application now.
Hi, Apopka. This is Kelsey Sauer for the first period DNN. And today I was wondering if you've ever wondered where you should go rock climbing before you hit up the Grand Canyon or Mount Everest. We're here today at Agui Rock Climbing Center, and I'm gonna show you how it's done. Let's go inside.
Agui is Orlando's number one indoor rock climbing center. For just one low price, you can climb the gym all day. Step one, fill out a waiver form. Step two, rent your equipment and put on your harness. Step three, take the introduction class. This is a perfect example of the double figure eight knot and the safety knot. Both are required before you begin to rock climb.
These are just the routes you can follow, and the numbers at the bottom, it goes anywhere from 5'6 to 5'12. The lower is the easiest, higher is hardest, and those are just different ones you can follow. We also have our bouldering area, which is this low wall over there, and people just climb low to the ground without a rope on that.
Hi, my name's David. I work at Agui Rock Climbing Center. The difference between outdoor and indoor climbing is indoor climbing, the holds are smoother. Outdoors, you have more rough terrain and the holds you can cut your fingers more on.
You are watching a master at work.
I am in the belaying position right now. I pull up the slack as the climber gets higher.
So did you like the climbing or the belaying part better?
Oh, climbing is the best. Climbing is great.
Okay, Apopka, this is Kelsey Sauer reporting from Agui Rock Climbing Center, and I think I'm ready to go climb Jackson Hole. Bye.
Want to wish someone good luck on St. Patrick's Day? Want a cookie? Freshman class will be pre-ordering cookies and messages during lunch on the Wells campus for over the next 2 weeks that will be distributed on the morning of St. Patrick's Day, March 17th. It's only 50 cents for a sugar cookie and $1 for the frosted cake style like you get at Publix.
Are you an aspiring poet, writer, artist, musician, or dramatist? If so, the National English Honor Society invites you to present your work at the Coffee House on March 21st at the Walls campus from 7 to 9 p.m. See Mr. Swirsky in room 311 on the Martin campus for more details.
Congratulations to the girls' water polo team for beating Timber Creek 11-5. Goals were scored by Rochelle Edmondson, Bobby Ogden, Kristen Hansen, Shauna Portilla, and Katie Walker. Congratulations to the boys' water polo team for beating Timber Creek 15-0. Goals were scored by Marcus Levitt, Justin DeSalvo, Andrew Gettle, Richie Hildebrand, Matt Lawrence, Tyler Costello, and Andrew Friedman. Sorry if I mispronounced any names.
And now to our other major news story for today from DNN reporter Nikki Richards.
Hey Apopka, this is Nikki Richards reporting for the first period DNN. I'm here at Old Town checking out all the entertainment down in Kissimmee, so let's check it out.
Old Town is located in Kissimmee off of State Road 192. It has 75 specialty shops, 8 delicious restaurants, and 18 thrilling rides, including the Schilling Shop that catapults 365 feet in the air. It is home to Florida's largest weekly car cruise with over 300 cars. Old Town holds birthdays, meetings, rehearsals, parties, or special events. Free parking, free admission. Hours are 10 a.m. to 11 p.m. every day of the year. Okay. How long have you been working at Old Town?
4 or 5.
4 or 5. And how do you like working at Old Town?
Yes, it's fun.
Do you see anything interesting?
Well, the people are always interesting.
All right. Thank you.
No problem.
I'm a magician at the Magic Store in Old Town, and how long have you been working here?
I've been working here since about 3:30 or so.
Oh, okay.
No, I've been working here since about a year and a half. A couple Augusts ago I started here.
Okay, how do you like working here?
It's a fun place. There's a lot of really fun stuff that you can do here.
And can you do a magic trick?
Absolutely, here, check this out.
Has the blank pages first?
Well, you can do whichever pages you want first.
No,
we take the crayons, we throw the color right into the book just like that, and when you do that, you end up getting all the colors right there. Now, if you shake it a little bit, what happens is you actually end up erasing all those colors. You never shake it too hard, because if you shake it way too hard, you erase everything.
Reporting for DNN. Many of you might have heard that Apopka is going small in a big way next year. We're having an academy. An academy is a small learning community within our larger high school. We will have 4 academies next year. Within an academy, topics of instruction are related to the academy area, which would emphasize on the arts, business, communication, or health and wellness idea in the articles that you study. Take a look.
The mission of Academy of Global Communications and Leadership is to promote student success by providing challenging educational activities and enhancing the students' understanding of law, broadcasting, communication, and citizenship as it relates to the world around them.
Okay, the academy I'm going to be in next year is Global Communications and Leadership. My major is going to be radio and television broadcasting, and my elective is going to be TV production 2, also known as DNN. I like this academy because it fits what I want to do when I grow up. It's probably going to help me get my start off in the right track for the future.
I'm Jonathan DeMarco, and I'm interested in making movies and being a star in the movies. In the Academy of Global Communications and Leadership, you can major in film studies or television and work on making films. You can learn about great movies like these and learn to make films by being in the Academy and taking a class like Intro to Film and Entertainment. You might be a star like me.
Government Association.
Counting all of this stuff.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to.
Sorry.
Hi, and what is your name?
My name's Natalie Costa. I'm a junior this year.
Okay, and what academy will you be in next year?
Well, I'm guessing the Communications and Leadership Academy because that's the one that I have to be an SGA.
Okay. And what class elective will you be taking next year in your academy?
SGA and my medical rotations class.
Cool. Why do you want to take this class next year?
I want to be an SGA because I love Mr. Peters and he's the most amazing person in the world.
Do you enjoy it?
I absolutely love this class.
Okay, and do you want to further your career in that field?
I do want to do SGA in college, but after college, no, because I want to be a doctor.
Say that you want to be a doctor.
All right, thank you, and bye-bye.
Feel this or not?
And performing arts seeks to nurture the creative spark that innately exists in every individual. Students will experience multiple facets of the art under the guidance of an exceptional faculty of artists and educators. The Academy will inspire a lifelong passion for learning and creativity.
Hi, I'm Chase Willis. I am a sophomore, and I will be in the Performing and Fine Arts Academy next year. I will be taking band as my class. And the reason why I'm doing this is because I really want to further myself as a percussionist and become a musician. And as you can see, I'm a part of the Apopka drum line and I'm a snare drummer on that line.
Hi, my name is Jenny Grisales, and the academy I will be in next year is the Fine Arts Academy. The elective I'll be taking will be drama. And I like to take drama because it provides self-confidence. You can tell a story through your body, and it's a really great way to entertain people.
Kevin Moore, she was special. She was Cassidy type. She was a daughter of the Duke.
Yeah, she was totally white. My God.
Hi, I'm Rachel. I'm going to be in drawing too. That's going to be one of my electives. And I want to take this next year because I've always loved art. I hope to become either a comic book artist or art therapist, probably both. And so that would help me a lot with both of those careers.
My name is Carla Connor, and I'll be going into the Performing and Fine Arts Academy. I'll be taking ceramics too, and I'm taking it because it's fun and I like being creative.
The mission of the Academy of Engineering and Business and Technology provides students with the interactive environment emphasizing the analytical, mathematical, and technological and organizational skills needed for success in modern business and in engineering and technology industries.
in the academy. I take graphic arts with Mr. Campbell. I like this class because we get to make keychains and magnets and all sorts of cool stuff.
My name is Leonardo Pacheco Jr. and next year I'll be taking Engineering and Technology Academy. Taking Web Design 1 in order to be able to create a website used for anything I might plan on doing in the future.
Hi, I'm Jeff. I'm in the drafting class. The academy I'll be attending is the Engineering and Technology Academy. I like doing drafting because it's a career I want to pursue. I enjoy it. It's a very fun class.
The mission of the Academy of Professional Health and Wellness is to increase student success by providing challenging educational activities in all classes, enhancing the students' understanding of health and wellness as it relates to their lives and the world around them.
I'm Daniel.
And I'm Will.
And next year we're going to be in the Professional Health and Wellness Academy.
As seniors.
As seniors. And we will, for the elective, we're going to be doing clinicals where we get out of class second and third period for a semester. And we go to different clinical-like places. And we observe and...
And learn.
And learn.
Hands-on.
Hands-on. We want to take it because we want to be doctors.
Or the medical field. Not really
good doctor. You don't want to be a doctor?
No.
What do you want to be?
Scientist. Anyways, something in medicine.
Hi, my name is Shirley Sisami. Next year I'll be in the Academy of Professional Health and Wellness. Next year I'll be taking marine biology. The reason why we want to take marine biology is because I want to be a marine biologist when I grow up.
Hi, I'm Stephanie.
And I'm Kelly.
And next year we're going to be in the Professional Health and Wellness Academy. We'll be in Child Development 2, which is a class where we get to learn how to teach preschool. And the reason we want to take this class is, well, I really love kids, and so we get to interact with them. And
the same here, and I'm going into pediatrics when I'm older, so it really helps me out.
Happy St. Patrick's Day! Bye!
Bye.
morning, Apopka. Today's March 20th. My name's Jonathan DeMarco.
And I'm Nick Nesta.
Our first announcement for today. Do you have overdue books due to the media centers? Bring them in this week during Fine Arts Week at either campus. And have your fine erased. The two media centers need books returned in order to prepare for the new media center. Bring back what you're not using. If it has late fee, it will magically disappear this week, March 17th through the 21st.
Schedules for next year go out Monday morning and need to be turned in by Thursday of next week. Make sure you pick your classes correctly.
And now for today's major story from DNN reporter Jennifer Grisales.
You walk by it every day. Are you curious to see what's inside? Hi, my name is Jenny Grisales, and my major story is about the new Apopka High School building.
Tour. This is a three-story classroom building, and then to the left of it, behind the trailer over there, is the next three-story classroom building. And then the low building over there is the new cafeteria. And over here, behind the last building that we can't see, is the new auditorium and the band suite and music suite and choral suite and all that. And the part that's sticking out a little bit is the admin building. And then this is the media center. So, and then where we're standing right now, this bare ground, will eventually become the gymnasium. But the current building has to be knocked down before we can do that. This will fit approximately 2,800 students. Right now, we're expecting to have, we won't have that many next year, so we should be okay for next year. But you have to remember, too, that one classroom building hasn't been completed, so we will have to use the Wells campus next year. They haven't given us a date when they'll start tearing it down. They're just telling us as soon as they can this summer. So what they want to do is for us to evacuate as soon as the normal school year is over. That's why we're holding summer school on the Wells campus. Once we get all our stuff out, then they'll bring in the wrecking ball. So when that is, I don't know. They just tell us as early as we can.
Okay. And about academies real quick, will we have to take, like, each building as an academy, or it's
no,
just...
No, it'll be all mixed up. I mean, it's just not feasible to make each building an academy just because of some electives. Some rooms were built specifically for some electives, so there's not a lot we can do about that. It'll be all mixed in.
Okay. Now that you've heard some information from Mr. Floyd, let's see what some of the students are looking forward to most next year.
What I'm looking forward to the most in the new school would have to be the air conditioning that doesn't break every other week.
I look forward to a cleaner environment, a better atmosphere, and a great senior year.
Well, I hope this video answered some questions that you might have had. I'm Jenny Grisales, and back to the studio.
Oh, hey, greeting AHS teachers. This is just a reminder of the in-service training tomorrow during your planning or Thursday after school. We'll be meeting on Martin campus in room 100.
100!
On the Wells campus in R12, the CRT room, instead of the conference room in the Wells administration building.
Instead of the conference room.
Due to the change in the registration process, it is mandatory that everyone attend who has 9th through 11th graders.
It's mandatory!
Thank you.
Tickets for the Spring Sports Assembly go on sale starting Tuesday, March 18th, and will be sold through Wednesday, April 9th. The Spring Sports Assembly will be held during the second half of 6th period on Friday, April 11th. Tickets are $2, and all proceeds will go to the Relay for Life. You can buy your tickets during all lunches on both campuses. Any questions, see Mr. Peters in room 321.
Attention! Spanish Honor Society members!
Members!
If you did not attend this week's meeting!
Meeting!
Please see Ms. Lowe before or after school to get your fundraising material.
Material.
All members needing a cultural event. Please check the cultural events posted outside Ms. Lowe's room. Gracias! And now for a commercial for next year's academies here at Apopka High School.
School.
Some dreams live on.
Wanted to learn how to play the guitar or find out how to record your voice and original music for a demo? Well, now is your chance. If you're interested in either learning to play guitar or wanting to learn more about recording digital music, please see Mr. Ellis on the Wells campus, room 302, right next to Mr. Scahill's room.
Do I look good? Trying to do it. Okay. I'm sorry. Hi, my name is Jeremy King, and I'm a senior at Apopka High School, and this is my student spotlight. my extracurricular activities. I'm very, very involved with my youth group at church, especially in the band. I was the backup singer when I started like 4 years ago. I became lead singer through times, and now I'm kind of student director over the whole entire thing. So I kind of direct them, get the music ready and learn new songs. And also the drama team at my church and organize different events. And me and my friend actually do a small group every Tuesday night. So yeah, I'm very involved with my youth group. My most memorable teacher has to be, I have a couple. When I was a freshman, it was Mr. Kuroz. He was my science teacher, coming at me on the honors course and everything, and he was really awesome. So Mr. Kuroz was amazing. Then I had Mr. Carey and Ms. Hobby and my 10th grade year, they were awesome. And I had Ms. Durham my junior year, she was really cool. I had a lot of awesome teachers. I guess the people who helped me the most throughout my years are Ms. Miner, Ms. Boot, Ms. Aldridge. They've done so much for me and kind of got me off where I'm going to go for college and stuff and really helped me. So yeah, those are some awesome teachers. If you have them, you're lucky. You're lucky. The hardest thing about high school for the past 4 years has definitely been time management. I'm kind of a procrastinator a little bit, especially when I had shows or did concerts and stuff, and you really have to keep up and schedule your homework and stuff, because I didn't do so good when it came to that. But definitely time management and doing your homework, that was really difficult, so yeah. Nothing. I will miss nothing about that. No, I'm just kidding. No, I will miss a lot of the people. There's a lot of like juniors and sophomores and freshmen that I've gotten to know over the past couple years and stuff, and I'll miss them. I definitely miss a lot of my senior friends and stuff, because it's really weird being a senior, knowing you're gonna go to college and knowing that you might not see some of the people you really got close to for a long time or ever again. Wow, that's depressing. But yeah, I'll definitely miss out by high school, the just getting to know people and stuff. Where do I see myself in 10 years? Well, I want to do the kind of the youth pastoring, writing plays thing, almost like casting Mark Hall from Casting Crowns. He's a youth pastor and he's in a band. I want to do that kind of thing, and almost like Tyler Perry, how he like writes plays and produces them and he's in them stuff. I want to do that type of thing. So that's what I'm going to school for. So in 10 years, I see myself youth pastoring somewhere, writing up shows and making music. Cross my fingers. Some things that people don't know about me is that I have gray hair. I've had gray hair since I was 2. It's hereditary. I'm not dying of a disease. Also, I listen to all types of music. I like everything from like Carrie Underwood to like Under Oath to Sierra. I listen to everything basically, except rap, and I don't really like fried chicken. And yes, I am still black. Yeah, but that's some things that people don't know about me. I can't eat KFC or anything like that. I'll get sick. I just can't. I can't do this. I get nauseous and like the grease and stuff. I can't. Why? Why would you do that? I mean, you're putting poison into your body and it get. I'm sorry.
Now to a commercial for the drama department's production of The Language of Angels.
I remember all my.
The Apopka High School Drama Department proudly presents
The Language of Angels.
On April 10th, 11th, 12th, and on April 16th, 17th, and 18th at 7:30, and on April 13th at 2:30.
A ghost story in 7 Caves in North Carolina.
A young girl disappears.
And her disappearance affects everyone involved.
You can buy tickets at the door. Mature audiences only.
In my life, I've loved them all.
Bye. We'll be right back.
And now to a video from Kelsey Sauer.
For the first period DNN, and today I'm here to help you fix the problem. Don't you hate it when you're in the heat of a game with your ping pong balls and it goes from being perfect to being flat because somebody stepped on it? Well, today I'm gonna show you how to fix this problem.
How to fix a dented ping pong ball.
Since fixing a ping pong ball involves fire, I put on safety goggles as a precaution. Here's the squish ball, safety goggles, fire, hold it over the ball, and watch the magic happen. Just like that, flat. Thanks for tuning in to Kelsey Sauer's How To, Apopka. Have a great day.
Tell me something, girl, what it is you have in store, she said.
And now to a video from Orange County Public Schools about character. Yay.
We're never gonna get this.
Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm Joey Fatone, and I am a graduate. That's right. Believe it or not, I am a graduate of high school. But believe it or not, I'm a graduate of Dr. Phillips High School in 1995. Wow, I mean, I pretty much remember like it was yesterday. I mean, before NSYNC, before Dancing with the Stars and the Singing Bee, I studied performing arts right here at DP. Now, there are a lot of people that helped me along the way, but there is one thing that I found that helped me pretty much all the time and most is the character trait trustworthiness. That's right. Now, being truthful, reliable, and having the courage to do the right thing is the meaning of trustworthiness. Now, no matter what you do, you always got to remember that people need to know that they can count on you. That's right. Now, when you have to be, you know, like when I'm at the studio or I have to be there to, you know, shoot a movie or something, they always rely, you know, for me to be on time and remember my lines and to be trustworthy. So with that, with your character education word for this month is trustworthiness. Now, watch how life runs smoother when people can count on you. So have a great year, have fun, and remember, trustworthiness.
Okay. Okay, Apopka, everybody have a great day.
Bye.
Hey, Apopka, I'm Rachel Strom reporting for the first period DNN. I went around asking many of you the question,
what would you think if the school were to have a 7-period day?
Why? 7 days? Or 7 periods? I can't even stand 6.
Who else got that?
I mean, come on, an extra period? It's worse. Study hall? Ugh.
Kaylee.
No.
Say, what do you think about 7-period day?
I think it's a bad idea.
Why?
Because the way they have it scheduled out, like per block, is going to be really hard to handle.
Casey, what do you guys think about a 7-period day next year?
Not going to say it's outrageous, because I like it.
You like it?
Not really.
Why would it make a difference?
Yeah.
7 periods, horrible.
I know, it is horrible.
Why?
Because
it's 7 periods.
That's the way it blocks scheduling.
Because it's confusing.
You're not in every class for 2 years. We're
about to walk Jamie, I need to tell me right now, why wouldn't you like a 7-period day next year?
Because I want to go home after school and not stay longer.
Well, there you have it, Apopka. There's some of the opinions about a 7-period day. I'm Rachel Strom reporting for the first period DNN. Have a great day.
There will be a cross-country meeting after school this Thursday, 4:24:08, in the gym for all students who would like to participate in cross-country next year.
There will be an important Red Cross Club meeting on Tuesday, April 22nd at 2 in room 33 on the Wells campus. We will be making plans for the upcoming blood drive and discussing officer elections.
Juniors, juniors, juniors. It's a tongue twister. Any member interested in being a member of the Senior Class Council for the class of 2009 should pick up an application packet in the front office or on the main campus or in room 606.
And now to a Senior Week video from DNN reporter Nikki.
Hey, Apopka seniors, don't forget that this week is Senior Week. Monday is College Day and the Scavenger Hunt, Tuesday is Senior Servant Day and the Talent Show at night, Wednesday, Senior Olympics and Out to Lunch, Thursday, High Class, R Class, and the Awards Night. Friday is Crazy 08 Day and the Grad Bash, so don't forget to participate and show everyone your senior spirit.
Polo banquet is Monday night at 6:30 at Roma Restaurante here in Apopka. Coach Russell needs a court account of how many people are coming and what they're planning to eat.
Now to our final video for the broadcast about voting for SGA from DNN reporter Jennifer Grisales.
Hi there, my name is Ross Black. I'm the student body president, and I wanted to let you know today how you can vote for next year's upcoming student government.
How do I vote? To vote, you will need your student ID and your password, and you can either go to the school libraries or use the computers to visit the website. And online polls will open at exactly 2 p.m. on Friday, May 2nd, and close on Friday, May 9th at 1 p.m.
Where do I get my password? During the fifth period lunches on both campuses in the cafeterias, the SGA room, 321, and Ms. Graham's room, R16.
When can I vote? You can vote after campaign week. Online polls will be open at exactly 2 p.m. on Friday, May 2nd, and close on Friday, May 9th at 1 p.m. Results will be announced at the end of the school day.
So that's it, Apopka. It's that easy. So go ahead, get involved with your school and vote today.
Bye, Apopka. Have
Make
a great
sure
day.
You vote. Bye.
Y'all ready for this? Let's go! Yeah! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
Senior Olympic winners, Wheezy Squad, Allison Dickens, Taylor Leffler, Kimby Martin, Courtney Berry, Diana Smith, Brittany Hardy, Derek Clark, Casey Richardson, Chad Mashron, Josh Ellsworth, Brandon, and Taylor Berry.
Man, I feel bad for those people. Have a great day, Apopka.
Robin Mowat and Jeremy Rouse competed in the track and field regional meet yesterday. Robin Mowat finished 7th place in the girls' long jump. Jeremy Rouse finished 1st place in the boys' long jump and 6th place in the 100-meter dash. Jeremy will compete in the state meet on May 2nd. Way to go, darters. Sorry if I mispronounced any names.
Congratulations to Jackson Trezen for his win in the round of 16 at the tennis state finals. He defeated Andre Stern from Parkland, Florida. Jackson lost in the quarter round final to the number one seed, Lawrence Condes from Fletcher High School. This is the first Apopka High School student to represent us at the tennis state finals. Good job, Jackson.
Attention class of 2011, applicants for general membership and the for the general membership in the 2008-2009 sophomore class council are now available in the Wells campus front office and in Ms. Graham's room, R16.
And now to a Did You Know video from Russell Kiefer.
Good morning, Apopka! I am Professor Abibu. I am here to tell you that you have a greater chance of getting hit on the head with a coconut, and dying than you do getting bit by one of my big, giant friends here. Oh, yeah. He's a scary monster. Arr. You got to swim.
There will be a French club meeting Tuesday, tomorrow, 4:29, from 2 to 2:30 in Ms. Graham's room, room 16. All members are asked to please attend.
And now to a video about the talent show from Rachel Strome.
Bye, Apopka!
Bye!
Woo!
Alright. Hey, Apopka. Did you know that every year, kids in North America spend close to $500 million on chewing gum? $500 million on this stuff.
Trying to reschedule the banquet. Please contact Lucy Beal, and money needs to be turned in by tomorrow to the front office.
Attention class of 2011. Applications for general membership in 2008-2009 sophomore class. Counselor now available in the Wells campus front office or in Ms. Graham's room R16.
And now to another teacher talk interview from DNN reporter Liliana Hercules.
Good morning, Apopka Blue Daughters. I'm Liliana Hercules here for a teacher talk interview for the DNN. Let's go talk to Ms. Gentile. And here we are with Ms. Gentile.
I teach regular reading to ninth graders, and I teach ninth and tenth grade reading to ESOL students. Well, I actually started teaching in 2001, and this is my third career. And when I started, I was teaching pre-K students with disabilities. So it's quite a change now. I've been here at the high school for 3 years, but I really love what I'm doing, and I really feel like I'm home now. Connection and the relationships that I form with my students, I really enjoy. The fact that they still come back to visit me, whether it be for a quick hello or an update or even a Hello Kitty Band-Aid or a mint, because I've got those too. Well, depending on whichever academy I get selected for, I definitely want to make sure to integrate the theme or the purpose of that academy with real life examples for my students. So I definitely want to teach differently. I want to teach gearing more towards whatever that subject matter is. To all of my students, anybody who's been with me knows that I always say ninth grade counts, and it's a wonderful opportunity for you to secure a great foundation academically for yourself by getting as great grades as possible and boosting up your GPA.
And that was our teacher talk for the DNN. This is Liliana Hercules taking you back to the studio.
Hi Apopka, it's Kelsey Sauer for the first period DNN. And today, my senior spotlight is on Kelly Johnson.
Hi, my name is Kelly Johnson and I'm a senior at Apopka High School.
Who are your most memorable teachers?
As far as learning at Apopka High School, I've had some really memorable teachers. Mr. Peters, Ms. Sims, Ms. Riker.
What are your plans for next year?
I plan on going to the University of North Florida and studying business and having a great time.
What was the stupidest thing you did in high school?
This is Jiner. The stupidest thing I did in high school was let all my friends that were boys put dinks and hit it and put scratches in it and just be mean to it and run into it.
Jump on it.
What was the hardest thing about the last 4 years?
The hardest thing about high school was learning how to manage your friends, your schoolwork, and partying at the same time.
What advice do you have for underclassmen?
Do your homework and study.
Where do you see yourself in 10 years?
In 10 years, I see myself married to a really rich guy. He's gonna be cute, by the way. And some kids and a really good job.
Good luck, Kelly. We love you. DNN1. Love, Kelsey and Rachel.
And now to a man on the street video from DNN reporter Michelle Gibson. My bad.
Today's Man on the Street question is asking a few seniors where they're planning to go to college.
Right. Tallahassee Community College is where I'm going.
College.
And then
UCC.
And then Florida.
University of North Florida.
I'm going to the University of Central Florida. Oh yeah.
You and
I? I'm going to Harvard, Law, Jella,
Stetson.
I'm going to UCC.
And now to a Did You Know video from Joe Bankson.
Good morning, Apopka. I am the former Duke of France, Auckland U. And I am here to tell you about Mountain Mauna Kea, a huge volcano under the sea of Hawaii. It is bigger than Mount Everest. It is a total of 33,476 feet. And I bet you did not know that. So now you know that Mount Everest is not the only huge mountain in the world. Yeah. Thank you. I'm here in place of Professor Abibu. Goodbye.
Hi, teacher. Our second teacher talk feature comes from DNN reporter Chris Mazzaro, who goes out and talks to a teacher here at Apopka High School.
Good afternoon, Apopka. I'm Chris Mazzaro, here with a teacher talk interview for the DNN. I'm going to be talking to Master Gunnery Sergeant.
What do you teach?
The question is, what do I teach at Apopka High School? I teach Marine Corps Junior Reserve Officers Training Corps course for 9th grade first year cadets at this school.
How long have you been teaching?
This is my 13th year at Apopka High School teaching ROTC.
What do you like about teaching?
I think the most enjoying thing about teaching is watching kids learn. And we do watch kids learn here at our school, and that's an enjoyable thing for me.
What will you do different in the classrooms next year with the academies?
I think because we have a driven course in ROTC, I will probably be doing the same thing. I will probably try to beef up the kids' motivation a little bit more.
What advice would you give students here at AHS?
Study hard, study long, and study forever, because you're going to need it when you leave Apopka High School. It's pretty hard on the outside, and you got to have a good education in order to survive, so you need to study while you have a chance to study.
Are there any extracurricular activities that you run?
Just drill team, PT team, and just extracurricular activities in ROTC.
Sam Friedrichs, we're here with a teacher talk interview from DNN. Let's talk to Mr. Anchel.
All right, here we are in Mr. Anchel's classroom. Okay, Mr. Anchel, what do you teach?
I teach world history, both honors and regular classes this year.
Who have you been teaching?
I've been teaching for 2 years here in Apopka and 3 years before that.
What do you do differently in your class now that we have academies at the school?
One of the main things I do different is try to incorporate the different interests of the students. Like if I was in the performing art ones or the ones that have interest in arts, incorporate more of the arts. If it was the global leadership, incorporate more of that into the class as well.
What advice do you give your students here at Apopka High School?
Well, the best advice is to always try your hardest. Never stop working to the full potential that you have, and enjoy learning, because if you stop enjoying, you're not going to ever learn anything.
Teacher talk for the DNN. This is Sam Friedrichs taking you back to the studio.
Color guard auditions will begin today in the 9th grade band room from 4:30 to 7:30.
And now to a Did You Know from DNN reporter Kelsey Bird.
Did you know that sneezes can travel as fast as 100 miles per hour?
Peace out, Apopka.
Bye.
Happy Cinco de Mayo.
Apopka, if you don't like new school time for next year, then you gotta find a school board meeting and protest this. Have your parents go to a school board meeting or call the school board and tell them that you don't like it.
I won't be able to pick up my little sisters from school in the morning, and I definitely don't want to practice at 6 o'clock in the morning.
I definitely think my job would be affected for after school because I definitely wouldn't get any hours, and driving during rush hour? Come on now.
I just don't want to play soccer in the morning.
I don't play football in the morning, guys.
I do not like this new school times. It's going to ruin water polo because we're not going to have anywhere to swim. And or that means we'll have to swim really early in the morning and it's cold and my nipples will freeze right off.
So Apopka, let's do something about this. This is JD signing off.
Valencia Community College will be on campus on Thursday, May 15th at 7:30 in the Apopka High School Auditorium to give the CPT test for those students interested in taking dual enrollment courses next school year. Remember, you must have an unweighted 3.0 grade point average to be eligible to participate in the dual enrollment program. Students may sign up during lunch in the guidance office on either campus. If you have taken the ACT or the SAT, you may already have the test scores and not need to take the CPT. Each teacher received a copy of the dual enrollment guidelines, so check with them to determine if you already have the scores.
Online polls will open at 2 p.m. on Friday, May 2nd, and close at 1 p.m. on Friday, May 9th. Student passwords will be given during fifth period lunches on both campuses for the next 2 weeks. Students may also go to Ms. Graham's room on the Wells campus, room 16, or the SGA room 321 on the main campus.
The National English Honor Society is currently accepting applications for membership for next school year. Please see Mr. Swirsky in room 311 for a membership application packet. And now to a Did You Know video from DNN reporter Nikki Richards.
Did you know that a blue whale's heart is compared to the size of a Volkswagen Beetle?
The Apopka High School Color Guard will be holding auditions on Thursday and Friday from 4:30 to 7:30 p.m. at the AHS 9th grade band room. Male and female students are welcome and no experience is necessary. Come learn to spin flag, rifle, and dance with us in 08 and 09. Visit us at www.apkaapopkaband.com for more details. And now to a Did You Know video from DNN reporter Kelsey Bird.
Some live for the bill, some kill for the bill. She whine for the bill.
Did you know that sneezes can travel as fast as 100 miles per hour?
And now to a student spotlight from DNN reporter Allison Dickens on the one and only Joe Bankson.
Hi, I'm Joe Bankson. I'm waking up at the start of the end of it'd have to be staying awake in all of my classes. The cars are moving like a half a mile an hour and I I think the stupidest thing I've ever done in high school was go around to different classrooms in an alien suit. It's pretty stupid. I'd say, don't get involved in too many things because you want to be great at one thing rather than not good at anything. I see myself on a platform with my name in lights, performing in front of thousands. No, I'm just kidding. I'm gonna be heavily involved in the ministry, preaching the gospel, man. It's all about Jesus Christ. What I learned in the school, but not in the classroom, is that people change, but those friends that you have, that you know you're really close with, you know, that friendship will never change.
Students, check the summer school brochure in your classes. A handout will be out soon. If you need a class for summer school, make an appointment to see your counselor ASAP. If you need a class not being offered, you need to sign up for Florida Virtual or Night School. If you're not pre-registered, there is a chance you will not be admitted on the first day. And now to a Man on the Street video from Dean and reporter Russell Kiefer.
Hello, Papa.
I'm gonna do a Man on the Street. I'm gonna ask you if you like the new time next year, 9:30.
Man, that's stupid, man. I'm gonna be here till like 4 o'clock.
How stupid is it?
It's really stupid.
I get like 5 minutes.
The new time is just gonna suck so bad.
How much?
Like this much. And
how much?
Like this much. Five times this. And I was talking to Coach Russell, and he said that if they did the time change, we're going to have to do water polo before school. And I don't want to get up at 7 in the morning and go swimming.
What do you think about that, Tom?
That video, in the car, we guys were high or whatever.
It sucks.
I thought
Coach was
so.
New time changes are gay. And if you support it, you're obviously a communist, and you shouldn't hate America.
You know what? I don't really care about the new time, because I'm not going to be here. I'm going to be in college, so... That's for you.
There will be a brief but important French club meeting Tuesday, May 13th at 2 p.m. in Miss Graham's room, R16. All members are asked to attend. And now to our special feature for the month. Teacher Talk. Our first Teacher Talk comes from DNN reporter Chelsea Chisholm.
Good morning, Apopka. I'm Chelsea, and we are here for a Teacher Talk interview for the DNN. Let's go talk to Mr. Peters. I'm here with Mr. Peters. What do you teach?
American History, American History Honors, and I'm the student government sponsor.
How long have you been teaching?
Well, it seemed like an eternity, but I believe it's about 12 years, right, Scooby? Yeah, 12 years.
What do you like about teaching?
The kids, mainly, in my subject area.
What will we do different in next year with the academies?
Well, it would depend on what academy I am in, but that would be adding additional content to the subject area. And also, I wouldn't possibly have a classroom near the bathroom.
What advice would you give to students here at Apopka High School?
Well, I would tell them to study hard and eat their greens. Right, Scooby?
Yeah,
Scooby and greens.
That was our Teacher Talk for the DNN. This is Chelsea taking back to the studio.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
And now to a commercial for the yearbook from Kelsey Sauer.
Yearbooks.
Hey, Apopka, listen up. Seniors, you can still buy your yearbooks today for $70, and underclassmen, you can still buy them on Friday. You can pay and pick up your yearbook in Ms. Springer's office, room 127, during sixth period. This awesome autograph book only costs $2. Make sure you buy one. And our second Teacher Talk feature for today comes from future DNN reporter Casey Burton.
Morning, Pop High School. I'm Casey Bird. We're here with a teacher talk interview for the DNN. It's your choice of drafting teacher. What do you teach here at Apopka High School?
I teach drafting 1, 2, 3, and 4, which encompasses mechanical engineering drawing, architectural drawing, architectural design, advanced applications of AutoCAD, introductory levels of AutoCAD, architectural desktop, pretty much anything that has to do with illustrated design.
How long have you been teaching?
4 years.
What do you like about teaching?
I enjoy teaching. I like working with the students that are here at Apopka High School. I like to try and provide them with the skill that they can use, hopefully in college or in their career that they choose.
What would we do different in your classroom next year with academies?
Well, the idea behind the academy is to be able to use different disciplines within one coursework, or to be able to illustrate the different disciplines that are used in one coursework. So I would probably be doing a lot more collaborating with core academic classes and implementing some of that stuff within my curriculum.
What advice would you give to your students here at Apopka High School?
The advice that I give students here at Apopka High School is just value your education, value your time, have a good time in high school. It's going to go by quickly, and it's something that you're going to want to look back at fondly.
That was our teacher talk for the DNN. This is Casey Burton taking you back to the studio.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, Popka.
I'm Kelsey Bird, and it's teacher talk day. So let's go to our first DNN reporter and our first teacher talk. Take it away, Patrick Whalen.
Patrick Whalen. We are here with another with a teacher talk interview for the DNN. Let's go talk to Mr. Cross. Here we are with Mr. Cross. So Mr. Cross, what do you teach?
Integrated science, regular and honor.
How long have you been teaching?
For 5 years, every year at Apopka High School.
What do you like about it?
I love the short hours that I have teaching. I love all the vacation time I get. I love the low stress environment. It's super.
So what would you do next year with the academy?
The academies next year actually have a focus on my examples. A lot of times I'm very random with examples and throw anything out, but once I know the focus of everybody in the class, it allows me to choose something and go for a year. In addition, I plan on trying to have a couple projects that involve that academy and probably spend some time with some other teachers and maybe do some group projects that way.
What advice would you give students here at Apopka High School?
For incoming freshmen is to come in with a good attitude, and you know, try to do things, ask questions, get involved. The more involved you get, the more excited you get about being in Apopka. And definitely start showing some class spirit. A lot of times freshmen don't have that much spirit, and they really need to do that and get involved.
That was our teacher talk for the DNN. This is Patrick taking you back to the studio.
Good morning, Apopka. I'm Jacob Wise here with the teacher talk interview for the DNN. Let's go talk to Mr. Hafner.
I'm here with Mr. Hafner.
What do you teach?
I am a ninth grade English teacher.
How long have you been teaching?
Actually, I was born to teach, so I've been teaching my whole life, but I've been here at Apopka for 2 years now. This is my second year.
What do you like about teaching?
What I like most about teaching is the pay. I think we get paid an absolute enormous amount of money to do an enormous amount of work. And the fact that I'm doing this job, the job that I love more than anything in the world, and just getting paid millions of dollars to do it, makes me absolutely thrilled to come to work every day.
What would we do different in your class next year with the academy?
The great thing about academies is that you actually get to choose, you get to choose something that you really want to do. And in my classroom, if you're going to be in the, let's say, the Fine Arts Academy, I would make sure that everything that I taught would structure around something that you guys as students would be interested in. A lot of times these days, you guys come to school and I hear a lot of kids saying, I'm bored, or I don't like this, or I don't like that. Well, if you're actually going to school and you're taking classes dealing with something that you're interested in, then hopefully it becomes a little more relevant to you. And believe me, if you're enjoying yourselves, then as a teacher, I'm enjoying myself. There's nothing worse than teaching a class of 30 kids that actually absolutely hate being there.
What advice would you give to students here at AHS?
The best advice I can give to my students especially is to come to school, be here every day. Especially those that take me. Why would you not want to be here if you have the opportunity to sit in my class every single day? It's an absolute pleasure. So be here and do your homework.
That was our teacher talk for the DNN. I'm Jacob Watts, taking you back to the studio.
Good morning, Apopka. I'm Ryan Moran.
Today for my teacher talk interview, I'm going to have an interview with Ms. DeMoss, world history teacher at Apopka High School.
Here we are with world history teacher, Ms. DeMoss.
Hey Ryan, the audience.
What do you teach?
World history, etc.
How long have you been teaching?
29 years.
What do you like about teaching?
It gives me an opportunity to at least feel like I'm making a difference in this world, and to help students to, you know, learn things that I really feel like will give them a better quality of life in the long run.
What would you do differently next year in your classroom?
Well, teachers are our students. They learn every year, and I try to take, you know, things that I learned this year and improve my classes next year. It may sound kind of hooky, but it's like being on a long-running Broadway show. You have to keep it interesting, not only for you, but for your audience. And yeah, I guess that'll be it.
And how would academies affect that?
It would affect the way I present my material. I would do, if, for example, if I were in the Arts Academy, that would lend more of a humanities approach to teaching history, where I'll bring in, obviously, more maybe a film clip or a literary work or a piece of art, and, you know, see how that would be reflected in history and that sort of thing.
What advice would you give students next year at AHS?
I think number one, to realize what a unique time in your life this is. That it's one of the few times in your life that you're going to be surrounded by people that really care about you and care about you being successful. And to kind of look at your classes as, you know, circuit training for the brain, and know that as you go from discipline to discipline, there's something you're going to be able to build your, you know, build strength in your brain and be able to really use those things.
All right. Thank you for taking the time to talk.
Well, you're darn welcome.
College will be on campus.
Hey Apopka, today is
the 15th of May.
And I'm Rachel.
Nikki.
And I'm Joe.
Yeah.
What up?
Hey!
What's up?
I'm Russell.
Nick.
Allison.
Alright, attention all seniors. This is very important. There will be a practice at the Amway Arena on Monday morning. That is before your third period exam. May 19th at 7:45 a.m. That's 7:45 a.m. Anyone planning on to participate in the graduation, you must be there. No exceptions.
No exceptions.
So make sure you're there at 7:45.
And now to a commercial for tonight's production from the K-R-A-P Music Theater Class.
Taylor is very well-rounded. She is a
a focused individual. She can go after something and take care of business. She's become a good athlete. She was always a good athlete, but she's mixed athletics with an excellent education. She's going on to the University of Florida, which is no easy task these days, so I'm very proud of Taylor. She's a wonderful, well-rounded individual. Happy to have her around. Sorry to see her go.
Hi, I'm Taylor Loveland. I'm a senior, the last graduating class of the Circle Halls.
What was your favorite thing about high school?
Probably being in a big high school like Apopka and being well known throughout the state for football and all sports.
Taylor, what were you involved in high school?
Lacrosse, swimming, NHS, junior class, sophomore class, SGA, and yearbook.
Taylor, what's your favorite class?
Anatomy.
Don't put cat juices on your face.
What will you miss most about Apopka?
I'll probably miss knowing all the streets and knowing everything about Apopka and being in such a little city, and then you go up and you're in a big city and you don't know anyone.
Do you have any advice for upcoming seniors?
Do your homework, study for tests, and don't goof off in class. Trust me, it helps.
Where are you going to school next year?
Florida, baby.
What are you majoring in college?
Sports management.
What do you want to be involved in while in college?
I'm hoping to play club lacrosse, and maybe my sophomore year I'll make the D1 team.
For
lacrosse. At UF.
And last but not least, what's your favorite DNN class?
I'm not really quite sure. I mean, I don't know.
All right, there will be a mandatory meeting for next year's members of student government this Friday after school, 2 p.m. in Mr. Peters' room, which is room 321.
Be there.
Or be square.
And now to our second senior spotlight from DNN reporter Jonathan.
Hi, I'm Hector Lewis Bermudez III. I am going to Florida International University.
Hold on.
I'm going to miss my friends and going to movies, football games, stuff you miss. But I think I have football in college. I'm going with Akeem Jones, Melissa Hughes. Some other things I don't really know, but it's gonna be fun.
Jessica.
This can't be the end.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go study software engineering. Hopefully, get internship somewhere big. You know? Teachers, Mr. Peters, Mr. Blevins, Mr. Hall. I don't know, I think that's it. Mr. Blevins, number one. Down.
The National English Honor Society is currently accepting applications for membership for next year's school year. Please see Mr. Skorsky in room 311 for a membership application packet.
Good job. And now to a teacher talk video from DNN reporter Shaq Scott. Oh.
Hi,
Shaq.
She's a teacher here at Apopka High School. So, Ms. Carter, what do you teach?
I teach French.
How long have you been teaching?
5 years.
What do you like about teaching French?
What I really like is to share my knowledge of French with the students. I like to develop their proficiency. When they start, they don't know any French, and when they finish, they are able to have a conversation in French, to read.
What would you be doing differently next year since we have an academy?
I am so excited. I will be able to differentiate my teaching according to the academy of the students.
What advice would you give to students here at Pop High School?
I would tell them to take French. It's a lot of fun.
All right, thank you. That was our teacher talk. This is Shaquille taking it back to the DNN studio.
Yeah. Yeah. Students, check out the summer school brochure in your classes. A handout will be out soon. If you need a class for summer school, make an appointment to your counselor ASAP. If you need a class not being offered, you need to sign up for Florida Virtual School or Night School. If you are not pre-registered, there is a chance you will not be admitted on the first day.
Ew. And now to our second teacher talk video from DNN reporter Desmond Picker.
I'm Desmond here for a teacher talk for the DNN. Let's go talk to Miss Richard. Here we are with Miss Richard.
She has like a crazy.
What do you teach? Wow.
Teach English 1.
How long have you been teaching?
This is my second year teaching English 1. This is my fourth year teaching. I taught 2 years of sixth grade English.
Yes, your boy Lil John. What do you like about teaching? It is.
What the thing I like most about teaching is interacting with the different personalities of students and just listen to them talk and discuss the different stories that we read.
Well, everyone else is just giving the take.
What would you do different in your classroom next year due to the academies?
Next year have more interdisciplinary projects that the kids work on that incorporate the different subjects and incorporate the theme of the academy.
Here I come. What advice would you give students here at Apopka High School? See you later, Apopka!
The number one thing that I would give to especially incoming ninth graders, high school is different from middle school. You have to put in some time into your classes and make sure that you're doing your classwork and your homework and all things that involve in getting a good grade. And if you have questions, ask your teachers.
Well, that was all for Teacher Talk with Ms. Richards. Let's take it back to the studios for DNN. See ya.
Hey.